Good day. Today I'm going to show you how I put Betaflight Lua scripts on my jumper T16 in just three simple steps. Lua scripts are just mini computer programs written in the Lua programming language, which is supported by the OpenTX system firmware. There are many Lua scripts available to do lots of things. However, the Betaflight Lua scripts I'm installing and executing today allows me to change video transmitter, GPS, and PID tuning values without the quad connected to a computer and without using my goggles. Sound interesting? Then give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing. Stop!
All right, the first thing we're going to do is go to this URL and download our Betaflight Lua scripts. And as you can see in Betaflight Lua scripts 1.4.0, they added support for the jumper T16, which is dated October 12th. System requirements is that you run OpenTX 2.3.1 or newer, and also they've added support for Betaflight 4.1. The latest release of the Lua scripts, however, is 1.4.1. So we're going to download that to a folder which I've already established. So we download the zip file. Downloading over here. And I'm going to put that downloaded zip file in the folder that I've already made under Betaflight Lua scripts. Paste. From there, I'm going to extract it. And it creates this OBJ folder. And within this OBJ folder, you have three different folders: BF, scripts, and sounds. These are the ones we're going to want to copy and paste on our SD card. We'll come back to that in a minute. All right, now what we're going to do is power on the T16 in bootloader mode by pushing T1 and T4 together and pressing the power button. And then we're going to plug in our USB cable. USB is now connected. And now what I've done with the USB connected is I've opened up two windows. This window on the left is my computer folder for Lua scripts under OBJ folder. These are the three files that we want to copy and move over to our SD card. And on the right is the window for our SD card of our jumper T16. So all we want to do at this point is take these three files, copy them, and paste them over here. Now, it's going to say that I've got files with the same name, and that's just because I've done this before, so I'm going to go ahead and say replace the files just for demonstration purposes. Now, all of these folders with the various files in them have gone to the appropriate locations on our SD card. And now for our bonus section. If you'd like your VTX page, which is currently page 8, to show up as page 1 when you execute your Betaflight Lua script, then you need to get a Lua script editor. And in my case, I just downloaded this Lua Edit free IDE debugger editor for Lua, and it shows up as Lua Edit. Just download and install a Lua editor, which will save your file as a .lua file. Then, before you transfer over your Betaflight Lua script files from your computer to your SD card, you'll want to edit one specific file. The file that you'll want to edit is under your OBJ folder, scripts, BF, and UI.lua. Now, I cannot take credit for this idea. I got this idea from Mr. Joshua Bardwell, or Josh Bardwell, or JB. So thank you very much, Mr. Josh Bardwell. This is the file you want to edit. So you open this up, right-click, open with, Lua Edit 2012. It opens up the UI.lua file. This line right here, local current page equals 1, you want to change that to the page number of your VTX page, or whatever page you want to jump to. If you want to jump to your GPS page, the first GPS page is page 9. I want to jump to my VTX page as the first page, which is page 8. So I'm going to change this to 8. Then you want to file, save UI.lua. And then you can close. Exit out. Now when I reopen this to confirm my save took place, I see that it's now changed to 8, which is what I want. From there, You just take these three folders like you did before, copy and paste them to your SD card, and then execute the program from there, and your VTX page will show up as page one.
Now that they're on the SD card, we can unhook the USB cable from the transmitter and exit out. Okay, now that we've got the Betaflight Lua script on our SD card inside our Jumper T16 transmitter, to get to it and to execute it, we press the sys button, S-Y-S, to get into the radio setup menu. Radio setup, press the page key once. And now you see that we've got this BF file folder here. Make sure that that's highlighted. Click the scroll wheel once. And within that folder, you see we've got bf.lua and bf.lua-c files. To execute the Betaflight Lua script, which we've uploaded to our SD card, with your quadcopter powered on, and if you're inside, the props off, just make sure to highlight the bf.lua file and click on it. And then highlight execute and execute. And there you see that we've got the options to change our PID values. And to navigate within the Betaflight Lua script, you can use the page key just as you normally would. Press it once to page forward once, and press and hold it to page back. And your various options within the Lua script are to change your PIDs. You see page 1 of 2 and 2 of 2. You can change your rates, advanced PID features, filters, motor stuff, video transmitter, which is one of the main uses for the Betaflight Lua script. Also, GPS rescue. Now, a good example of this is if you happen to have a GPS rescue set up on your quadcopter and you've got a telemetry receiver, obviously, if you're using the Betaflight Lua script, that you've got a telemetry receiver, then you can actually put the number of satellites as one of your telemetry values on your transmitter screen in one of the widgets. And for instance, if the minimum satellites is set to 8 and you get to a spot where you're only picking up maybe 5 to 7 satellites and you see that on your widget, then right away you can just use your transmitter to go into the Betaflight Lua script, the GPS rescue page, and change your minimum number of satellites. To change these various options, you just click on it with a scroll wheel like you normally would and use it to change your options. So that's how you make changes to it. Now, once you've made changes, to save your changes, the changes are only applied for the one particular page that you're on. To get the options for saving your changes, you need to click and hold the scroll button down. And then you've got this menu that pops up that says Save Page, Reload, or Reboot. Now, obviously, if you made changes and you want to save them, then you click on Save Page. If you made a mistake and you want to go back to the default values or the values that you had in here prior to making changes, then you hit Reload. I'm going to go ahead and click Save Page so that you see how this is done. And now it's saved. To get out of here, you press and hold the return key, and it goes back to your SD card, and then you just navigate as normal. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate how you can change the values of your VTX with this Betaflight Lua script. Now, to do this little real-time demonstration of the Betaflight Lua scripts, what I've got set up here is my Eosheen ROTG-01 Pro receiver hooked up to my Android phone. This receiver, together with the app on the phone, forms an FPV display. What you're seeing is the view from my FPV camera on my workbench. This is a handy little device for your workbench or for spectators while you're doing some actual flights. If you're interested in this product, I've got links to it down in the video description below. We're going to execute our Betaflight Lua script by pressing down and holding this SYS button, getting into radio setup, going to our SD card menu, BF folder, press enter, and press enter. This brings up the first page. I know the VTX settings are towards the end of the menu pages, so I'm going to press and hold the page key
That gets me to GPS rescue, press and hold, and that takes me to the VTX page. It's currently on F2 at a power of 200. Let's go ahead and change this to F4. There, I made the change, but our FPV display didn't change at all. Why is that? Well, simply because we didn't save the page yet. Remember, for each page, you need to save it. Press and hold the Enter key, save page, and this should go out. And it did, so it worked. Now, on this little device here, the way to get the frequency back on your FPV display is just press and hold this button and it'll scan it. And it'll find the peak frequency right here. And then once it's done scanning, it'll go to that. Now, as we're waiting, you can go ahead and make the same changes using the Betaflight Lua script to your band or your power as well. And now we're locked in at F4. And that's how you use Betaflight Lua scripts to make changes to your VTX or any other options that you have available to you.
So that's how you can download, install, and execute the Betaflight Lua scripts with your Jumper T16 transmitter. Another one of the fun features brought to you through OpenTX, Betaflight, and the multi-protocol module developers who you can support through links in the video description below. If you found this video useful, make sure and share it with your friends. Thanks for your time and your support of your TMac FPV channel. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.